I never thought much about elevators. In a city as dense and vertical as this one, they were part of the background noise, a constant in the day-to-day. You pressed a button, waited for the doors to slide open, stepped inside, and that was it. A short, mindless trip to wherever you needed to be. No one ever gave them a second thought. But now, I can't stop thinking about them. Specifically, that elevator. It was a Wednesday when I first noticed something was off. I had just started a new job in one of those sleek, high-rise office buildings that seemed to touch the sky. The kind of place with polished marble floors, walls of glass, and lobbies that echo your footsteps. My office was on the 27th floor, which meant I used the elevator several times a day, like everyone else in the building. The day had been long, full of meetings and deadlines, and I was one of the last people to leave. It was already dark by the time I stepped into the elevator, and the office was mostly empty. The hum of fluorescent lights was the only sound as I pressed the button for the lobby. The doors slid shut, and the familiar hum of the elevator began. I leaned back against the wall, staring blankly at the floor numbers as they lit up one by one. But then, somewhere around the 18th floor, the elevator jerked suddenly, like it had hit something. Not hard, but enough to make me straighten up, my pulse quickening. The lights above the door flickered, and the elevator stopped. Just like that, it went still, the hum of motion replaced by an unsettling silence. I stared at the numbers above the door, waiting for them to change, but they didn't. I was stuck. I pressed the button for the lobby again. Nothing. I pressed the emergency call button. Silence. No response, no intercom crackling to life. I tried to stay calm. Elevators got stuck all the time, right? Someone would notice soon. But as I stood there, my hand hovering over the emergency button, I felt the air change. It was subtle at first, almost unnoticeable, but the longer I stood there, the more I realized something was wrong. The air was thick, heavy. The small, enclosed space felt like it was closing in on me, even though I knew that wasn't possible. Then, from somewhere above me, I heard a noise. A faint, rhythmic clicking. Slow at first, like the sound of gears turning in the walls, but growing louder. I looked up, expecting to see something malfunctioning, but the ceiling was just a smooth panel, featureless except for the vent. The clicking grew more persistent, faster, and I could feel it reverberating through the walls, like something was crawling through the shafts, something mechanical. I stepped back, my heart hammering. The clicking sound stopped abruptly, and for a moment, everything was still. Then the lights went out. Total darkness. My breath felt stuck in my throat as I fumbled for my phone. The small screen, the only source of light in the pitch-black elevator. The silence felt suffocating, but there was something else. A presence. I can't explain it, but it was as if I wasn't alone anymore. The space felt different, like it was filled with something. Something I couldn't see. I reached out, my fingers brushing the cold metal of the elevator wall, trying to steady myself. My phone screen flickered, and for a brief second, the floor beneath me seemed to shift, like the elevator was moving again, but not in the way that it should have been. It was a strange, disorienting feeling, like the elevator was slowly drifting sideways, not up or down. I pressed myself against the wall, trying to rationalize what was happening. Maybe it was a power outage, a technical glitch, but deep down, I knew it was something more, something I didn't understand. Suddenly, the elevator jolted again, and the lights flickered back on. The floor display above the door read 27 again, as if nothing had happened. I exhaled shakily, pressing the button for the lobby once more. The elevator resumed its descent without further incident, the familiar hum returning, but my pulse didn't slow. When the doors finally opened in the lobby, I nearly ran out, my heart still pounding in my chest. The security guard at the desk looked up from his phone, raising an eyebrow. "You all right?" he asked, his voice indifferent, like this was just another day. I nodded quickly, not trusting myself to speak. My legs felt shaky, but I forced myself to walk calmly out of the building, trying to shake off the feeling of unease. The cool night air hit me as I stepped outside, and I finally let myself breathe. For the rest of the week, I avoided that elevator. I told myself it was irrational, that I had imagined the whole thing. Maybe it had been a mild panic attack, triggered by exhaustion. But no matter how much I tried to convince myself, I couldn't shake the memory of that clicking sound, or the way the air had felt so thick and wrong. The following Monday, I decided to take the stairs, even though that meant an exhausting climb up to the 27th floor. As I passed by the elevators, I saw a maintenance worker standing by one of the doors, his toolbox open on the floor. He was muttering to himself as he unscrewed the panel above the door. "Excuse me," I called, trying to sound casual. "Was there something wrong with the elevator last week?" The man looked up, his face tired and lined with age. He wiped his hands on a rag and shook his head. "Not that I know of," he said. "We've had complaints here and there, but nothing major. These old elevators can be finicky sometimes." I nodded, ready to move on, when he added, almost as an afterthought, "But it's weird, though. You're not the first person to ask about it this month. One of the tenants swears they heard something in the walls, said it sounded like..." He paused, tapping his screwdriver against the metal door, like someone else was in there with them. I felt a chill run down my spine, and I quickly thanked him before walking away, my steps quicker than before. I didn't ask any more questions. I didn't want to know. But now, every time I walk past the elevators, I listen. And sometimes, in the quiet of the early morning or the late evening when the building is almost empty, I hear it. The faint, rhythmic clicking from deep within the walls. I haven't taken the elevator since.